What's going on, guys? It is SpotTheOzzie here, and as you can tell, there's a bit of confusion because in my webcam, I'm currently wearing a black and red top and also a red hat, which is different to the blue and black that I usually wear. But I thought, you know what? We're racing with Team China Dragon Team Racing. The race team is red and black, so why not go red and black for the rest of the series until the end of this championship? So give this video a thumbs up if you're liking the red and black look. If you're not liking the red and black look, give us a thumbs down, and maybe I'll go back to wearing blue and red, or blue and black. But there's going to be a lot of confusion between the first round and the current round that I'm doing a video on. So the patch came out, and we did the first race. At the end of the first race, it crashed. The game crashed and it didn't save. So then I had to redo the race and I re-recorded it, and then it crashed again. And then I did it again and it crashed. So eventually I got on the Steam forums and was having a look around, and people had fixed this issue by turning off the auto save. And what I did was I ran through race one again, and I didn't record it this time because I'd recorded it so many times and a lot of footage had become wasteful. And it actually finished the race and it let me save after the race manually. But obviously the results of that race is different to what actually happened in race one when I recorded it 5 to 6 races ago, you know, when I first crashed in the first place. So what had happened was, instead of Partnan coming third, Lara came third and Partnan came 9th, whereas Lara got like 16th because the car fell apart just at the checkered flag. I ran Lara with the better car, the more reliable components that is, and I stacked their car. So everything, what you saw in the first video leading up to, it's all the same. I did the part fixes for the gears, no, for the brakes, sorry. I did the reliability just for one driver, and then turning the air on, and then I just stacked one car into one driver, and that's how it worked. It was actually a really good race. What I found was, when I ran that race a few other times before it, when it crashed, is that it's going to be very difficult in this championship to consistently score at the top. And it's all about just making sure we get the car in the right window. Qualifying has to be done well. But anyway, let's pick up from there. So at the moment, we're 3rd and 9th in the championship, which is a good start for us. We're working on our brakes and our brakes only, just to get them in the right window. They're currently 6th best in the championship. So by improving those parts and by stacking our improvability star when we design the chassis, it's going to give us a huge benefit. At the moment, I'm still working on one car's components only, just to stack them. I am fixing the brakes just for Partnan's car, and I'm just going to keep stacking Lara's because Partnan has hit his peak. At 4 stars, he's hit his peak. If I go to the drivers, Partnan has hit his, as you can see there, Partnan 4 stars of 4. Lara just about to hit 4 stars, and she still has a bit of room to go. So there's still a bit of improvement to be made there. But more importantly, nothing else has changed. The sponsors, there's nothing juicy there left. It's all just the higher tier, 1st, 2nd, or above, and we'd never get that. So I'm hoping that, you know, that one expires and we get a better offer that can offer us something around the 3rd, 4th, 5th, or 6th mark. Finances, we are making money due to sponsors, the chairman payments, and the drivers actually paying us through their sponsors rather than we paying them. So that was, if you're unsure what I'm talking about there, go watch the first video, and I clearly explain why I'm getting more money out of them as drivers. As for everything else, if I just quickly go through, there's nothing really else to report on other than just skip to the next couple of days. So we're going to skip here a couple of days later, get to the brakes, and this is where I'm going to start flicking our reliability to the other areas of the car. And what I'm going to design next. Now, I had a little bit of a look at the track schedule. So because whatever we design now won't be ready for Yokohama in terms of reliability, I looked at Beijing, Tondela, Black Sea, Munich, and Cape Town. And what you can see out of rounds 3 to virtually round 7 is, round 8 I should say, is the acceleration is crucial. So it's really crucial that we start designing the better components for our gearboxes, because they take like 11 days. That's a very long turnover time. So I'm going to start to design them. This is going to be our first one, straight off the bat. A lot of money. It's going to be about $1 million plus each time we build one of those. Let's have a look at our reliability. And cool, it's already up to 58% because that component was built with a bonus from our star mechanic. And now that they're all up to 65%, I'm not going to keep repairing just Lara's car. I just want to start repairing everyone, all the other parts as well. So I'm going to start to look at the engine and other stuff for partnering as well, because otherwise we are going to screw him out of, you know, being within this championship at all. It's actually really hard to balance both cars. So I think it's a good tactic, if you're watching this, to stack one car with the better components. And that's purely because it's a tough game. And we just want to get one guy through in the checkered flag, in the green, as fast as they possibly can go. So yeah, it's a tough game to balance them out, to be honest. I might just see how much that kind of heals the reliability of the cars, and then I'll stop it in a couple of days and check if there's anything else I should start fixing. Just have a look at the air conditioning. Stop there. Pause. Go down. Have a look. They're still all coming to grips, aren't they? All right. I mean, that's about it that we're going to be able to fix for one of those cars. We might have to start just fixing what we can just to get them across the line. Unfortunately. And who else? That part there, because that's got a lot of room for improvement. And we'll let those parts start to get repaired. What else do we have now that we're there? 58. I want to start doing that one. Engine, 58, 47. That suspension's going to be really rocky. It's going to be really rocky, but it is what it is. And here we are. First race. Chairman's Happiness is very delighted. And I just want to see... I want to see those brakes put us up. They're still in 6 because they didn't, you know, they weren't much higher. We still have to improve them. I'm going to do 7th or above. I still think it's very optimistic to go 3rd or above. I'm sure we can get 7th, but I'm not sure if we can get 3rd. It's going to be very difficult. I'm going to stack super soft tyres and also softs, and those only, because that's the kind of strategy we're running on at the moment, is just those two sets of tyres. And will I only race? Let's just go with that. It's hard to know. How long will the soft tyres go? It's 14 laps, 5 kilometres, very technical circuit. We've been here before. Because I only like to stack one tyre. Super softs. I think super softs will be the way to go. We won't need 8. I think 8. So if we go 7, 1, 2 for practice, 3 for qualifying, 2 for the race. Yeah, 7 should be enough. 7 should be plenty of meat. And we'll go super soft just in case we decide that super softs are the way to go. Part fitting. It's going to be all stacked for our good friend Lara's car. I might give her that one. It's an illegal component. It's all right. Lara. That's all good. And we are going to start our first practice session of round 2. Anyway, guys, keep giving me your comments and feedback. I'm reading every single comment. What do you think about the patch so far? I don't know. I'm indecisive. There's been a lot of feedback on people in the forums, on other players, saying the patch isn't that great. It doesn't work. The blue flags aren't as effective as they used to be. They've gone backwards in some ways. It's one of those really sticky situations. So I imagine we're going to want high downforce. Could be completely wrong here, but we're going to... That's how I imagine the car would want to be set up, right? Speed. Soften the suspension. Very windy track and then very fast, isn't it? So I might just leave it at that. Go on the softs. Yeah, super softs is the way to go. Look at it. It's 10 laps versus 10 to 12. Yeah, because we're going to have to do a stop. We always have to do a stop. And we're going to change party's car to softs as well. What are we doing? His setup. Let's just try that. Let's see. Let's try the other way with the gear ratios. Let's pull them up a little bit. Softs. And away we go to take our first practice for the weekend. How have you guys been, though? I know We've got a couple of guys who love to comment on these videos. Indie Brony, Michael Cornwall, Kickass, 145. There's a couple of new guys who have just jumped on in this season that are starting to comment as well, which has been really cool. Trying to think who else. There's a lot of people. There's quite a few people that I constantly see. They call me Jerry. And every single time you guys have made a comment, I've been able to take it on board. Like, you should have done this, you should have done that. I've been like, oh, okay, fair enough. You know, we can do that better, we can do this better. I might just turn off my headphones. Okay, that's enough. And yeah, it's been great. So we're going to bring them both in so we can start to just fine tune the cars and get them in that window. It might be a little hard at this circuit because it's very... Ooh, excellent, great, excellent, straight off the bat. And we are on fire, 95%. Wow. I don't think we've ever done that straight off the bat. Maybe we have. If you remember that we've done that before, let me know. That is a first. I just want to check. Okay. I wanted to check Lara's car to see if it was better. Nah, it's worse. So I already know it's going to be the suspension. And a little bit of downforce needs to go away. And I'm keen just to try that. Center out, same tires, qualifying trim. Alrighty, what are we gonna do with you? Let's try that. See if it's the right or wrong way. I think it might be the wrong way, but we'll see. Send both cars out. Bring in. Looks like there's a lot of different tires being operated out there. A couple of mediums, a couple of softs. Only a handful of super softs, which is interesting. I just feel like the performance out of these tires versus the duration of like doing one stop or not doing one stop would be too great for us. Plus, I have to check up on our car at the moment in terms of their reliability. Okay, so the handling went the wrong way. So we're going to have to go back this way. Or for you, it's going to be this way. Looking at it. So it was there, and that was better. And we're going to have to go back that way. Okay, let's try this. Super softs as well. Qualifying trim. Okay, so Lara is a little bit more happy with that setup. 91%. Excellent for downforce, which is right on that window. Stiffness has to go up, in my opinion. Gearing to come down. Yeah, I think it might have to be a little bit greater than that, but let's just try it. Get them out there. Grind down and do some laps. How's the track weather? 26 degrees. So it's going to be a hot one. It's not going to be that cold. So for anyone first coming into this first video and it's your first time watching, so basically I just bring them in straight away because the drivers give me feedback. You don't have to do lap upon lap upon lap to get feedback. The driver will give you feedback upon just their initial response when they go out, and then you can start to fine tune those setup changes. Excellent, excellent, excellent. So that's great. So what are we going to do? We're going to go to race trim because we've just hit level 1 in qualifying trim, which gives us a 5% bonus in performance for qualifying. To race trim, and we're just going to get him to do how fast is a lap around here? 12 laps, just burn as many laps as you can. And you know what, we might actually do 8 should be enough to get around on. And yeah, it says all excellent, but the optimum balance is 97%. Isn't that funny? So it's not right perfect, but it's almost there. So I don't want to make any adjustments. You know what? I think I might just adjust this a little bit and see what he comes back with from there. He might like it, he might not like it. But there's no point just doing one single lap. And Lara likes the car a lot more. It's now excellent, great, excellent. And it's 98%. So she's actually has a preferred optimum setup. And it's one less feedback-wise. It's great, not excellent, excellent, excellent. So I don't... Yeah, that's a bit of a funny one for me. I might leave that as well. I might just change one little thing. Let's just do that. See if it gets it in that window properly. And we're going to go to race trim. We're going to get her to do 8 laps as well. And this is just a splash and dash of just doing lap after lap after lap. just to get that active knowledge bonuses up on those tires. Get them into overtake mode, so they got 10 laps of fuel right now as they go out, which should be a lot, should it not be? Let me have a look. Yeah, if they're doing 1 minute 17s a lap, and that's the fast lap, we'll probably be doing about 1:23. A minute 23 with 12 minutes to go, mathematically, a 1:23, or almost a 1:30. Six laps. It's almost about 7 laps. So I'll do 7 laps on this fuel, and they'll do that easy. So this will be fuel enough for the entire session, unless they burn through it too much on the overtake mode. I don't think they will. I think their tires are actually going to keel over before anything else. And if that's the case, I might bring them in just to change tires, and that's really it. 44% and 48%. This is a bit of a test as well to see how far they can go on super softs. And look at those tire, look at those advantage points going up. This is great. Both setup knowledge is excellent and great. And what are their lap times, more importantly? Lara's 20th and Partanen is 15th. But as more fuel is burned off, the faster they should go, because the fuel around here is about 0.25 of a lap. So that is one extra lap of fuel equals 0.25 slower, just based on how heavy the car is, which is pretty amazing in some ways. So she is now at 24%, so we're going to bring her in, send her out, and all we're going to do is just grab a new set of tires, which is going to leave, yeah, 3 sets for the race. That's fine. That's perfect. 4 laps of fuel, boom. Get into overtake mode. Same with Partanen. Is he? Yeah, he's just going to be limping around on those. So let's get him to come back in. Active race trim is up to level 2. Will it get to level 3? Maybe not. It might not be in that window to get, you know, exactly there, but that's alright. So we're going to send him out. Tire choice, slicks, stints, race trim, 4 laps. Send him out, boom. And away he goes. We're literally just trying to get up that active race trim as high as it possibly can go. I should have probably checked the setup to see if he had any greater feedback from then, from the last session, but we'll see when we're just about to go into qualifying. And yeah, that's really just it tuning it. So just enjoy the laps around here. Maybe we can watch a lap of Holtz as she goes around. Does she take any different driving lines? I do like her car, though, with the blue and white. Kind of has that old Benetton feel, you know, the 1995-1994 Benetton. Remember, they're both enjoying the setup. They're much slower, aren't they, in practice, while they're going faster. And will they get into race trim level 3? That would be amazing if they did. I think they might be able to just get into it. Yes, so we're going to have performance 15% additional because of that unlock, so that's going to be huge for us. So we timed that perfectly. Anyway, a 20 minute session for me is a very long practice time that they've given us. From the prior championship, I think it was like 15 and then it was like 10 minutes, so I feel like that's a long time to be practicing essentially, but you know, if it's the difference in getting us in that right window, then, you know, let it be the difference. But it's interesting to see that there's a lot more cars out here on medium. So does that mean medium tires? Does that mean they're going to be doing medium in the race and potentially going the full 14 laps without pitting? That would be crazy if they did. Who are we waiting for? We're not waiting for anyone. So we're just going to get straight into qualifying. I just want to do a quick check for their setup from that last stint. And how are we? Active selection, qualifying trim. We're going to do super softs. I'm going to do sweet spot. And we're going to do Partanen is qualifying trim and also super soft tires. Car setup. Let's have a look. How do we go? 97. I did nothing. In fact, we're going to go back. Sorry. We're going to go back to the 98% setup. That's fine. Current tires. Good, 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 good. And as for Partanen, how is he? 97, didn't change anything. In fact, he went from 97, excellent, 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 to 97, excellent, great, excellent. So let's just leave it there. And we're going to have enough tires for the race. And this is it. We're going to take qualifying, guys. This is the big session. Now, with a track of a minute and 20 seconds to get around, I should technically be able to do 3 flying laps if I send the cars out straight off the bat. So I'm going to do that with Partnan's car because he doesn't have as big as a sweet spot as Lara when it comes to qualifying, and I'll explain that in just a minute. As you can see with his car, see those green areas, the brake temp and tire temp, they're only very small. Lara has a bonus that opens up that gap from her mechanic, if we pick that as active knowledge, to make those a lot bigger, so you're able to get the tire temp and brake temps in the optimum range without suffering any downsides of going into the red zones or being overheated or being too cold, which is cool. This guy will not stop finish, will not get off my tail. Just look how glitchy this is. See, the cars I want to pass, I'm in cooldown mode, I'm cooling them down, I'm cooling them down, and no one is going to make a pass just yet. That's what I find crazy about this. This needs to be fixed, in my opinion. We're sitting on the race line, but even so, the other cars should be able to go. And now everyone's just getting underneath us. And now we're going to start to speed up. Perfect for tire temp, perfect for brake temp. This is the way we're going to start. And I'm just going to send Lara out right now just to do her lap. How do we go? We're going to put her back in the 98%, which she already is. And away she rolls for her lap. Partner starting his flying lap. Hopefully no one gets underneath him, and that's not going to be the case because they all get choked up at turn one with each other. If no one's able to catch up to him, then he should be able to keep a flying lap here, but there is a slower car and we're going to get balked. So this is actually going to be very difficult to get all the cars in the window. He did set the fastest first sector of all the cars that are completing one right now, but he's just gotten balked, and I think someone else has just overtaken him that's on their flying lap as well. So this is going to be really difficult to nail a time with this many cars out on the track and with such a small track of a minute 20. So it's going to be really important to try and get both cars on that pressure. Look at that. Wow, cars are going to be flying everywhere. They have to take a tighter line when that happens. That's okay. We're going to slow her down. Slow her down quite significantly. She has a pretty big gap behind her. And we're going to start speeding up now. So she's got great tire temp, overheated brake temp, but that's okay. The main thing is that she's got a bit of a gap, provided the car behind her does not catch up. Partner goes fifth, and he goes fifth in the mid of that pack, and that pack all got held up by one another. And we might only be able to get one more lap out of Partner, given that the time it's taken to come around, go out, and do our little dance. That's really unfortunate. What is happening here? Lara is going to get held up by this car doing its out lap as well. How big of a difference is it going to make? She's down by 0.5 at the first split. She'll probably be down a lot more after that split as well. Where are we? Where are we? Let's just speed it up a little bit here. She's got another slow car ahead of her. And this is just basically a war of attrition. And it's going to start to rain. That's going to be devastating if it doesn't get any... Wow. Lara goes 13th and Partner's 14th as the rain starts to come down. And it's starting to come down pretty hard at the moment. And it won't cool down until the end of this session. So we're definitely only going to be able to get one more lap in. If it's going to be a fast lap, that's going to be highly debatable as the track grip goes down while the rain washes it away. So that's really stuffed up our lap. So I'm watching Partner. I'm going to be watching him to send him out as soon as the track grip goes up, and it looks about in 4 to 3 minutes, the track grip is going to go back out, so we should be able to get one more attempt out of this. It takes about 2.5 minutes to do an out lap, but right now it's all about just getting them out in the right window with the right tires, and we're going to risk it. We're going to hold off as much as we possibly can and send him out when there's less cars, and at the moment there is less cars. And that's only going to keep climbing as the track group goes up. We want to send him last minute as we possibly can. This is going to be huge for us. If we can just get this right. What time do we want to send them out? About 3 minutes. I don't want to send them out behind each other back to back to back because that might stuff each other up. But anyway, everyone, there's a lot of cars going out on intermediates. as it looks like it's going to keep raining. It's just going to get worse. So if we send out partner now, we might be able to do a quick lap as it dries out. I'm not sure if this is actually going to work. Same with Lara. Get you out on tires as well. This is not going to work, is it? The track is just changing as we're speaking. This is going to be really unfortunate. It looked like we might have been able to get that window in. I just can't see the benefit of going out on intermediates. There's no way you're going to be faster out on intermediates than you are on those other tires. So I want to send partner to go out as fast as he possibly can. And it's... See how it's dried up, but most of the cars going around now are on intermediate tyres, so there was a small window to do it. It looked like from our forecast it was going to be fine to go out, but the rain has just started again, and it's been very unpredictable. So I might get partner to keep going around, and hopefully he doesn't get caught out by the rain too much. And now I'm going to get Lara to just speed on, why not? There's a bit of a gap here for the partner now to kind of kick off his own lap. This is going to be devastating. Let's just start this fast forward process. His tires are too hot, but it's... Oh, maybe the rain might cool them down. But the whole idea was just sending him out to get around as fast as possible good so he doesn't get held up. What's his lap going to be like in these conditions? He's down by 4 seconds. Lara? Yeah, she's going to be down by even more. By 6 seconds. So it's a complete waste for us, unfortunately. Don't know what to say there, but it's happened. There's one guy on Super Softs as well, Surikov. He's going to definitely go slow. He's down by 11 seconds. So the rain might play into this final race, or into the Sunday, I should say, for the race to start. But yeah, it's shocking. If we were able to get a good lap in the first lap, like in the top seven, we would have definitely have held our spot and been able to take it by storm. But that's not going to happen here. As all the cars cross, they finish up their series. It might be a bit of a mixed grid because a couple of the slower guys might have been able to do faster laps in the first half of the session, and then everyone else has gotten caught out. Holtz, who's one of the top, you know, is in the top team for this championship and was our main rival last season, has come first. So this is going to be scary. Look at everyone coming into the pits. They're all just submerging into there right now. It's like five wide into the pit lane. Who are we waiting for? So let's have a look at the forecast for the Sunday race day. I want to see if this is going to be a rainy day. I can't believe the telemetry for us was completely off. It was on and then it just didn't change for us. So it's going to be a cloudy, sunny day apparently. And what active knowledges are we going to pick? Super soft tires. Yep, that's right. For both cars. And pick... I don't want to do risk. I'm going to do super soft tires as well. Car setup is fine. There's no need to adjust anything there. Driving strategy is attack for both. And I'm going to get them into the overtake mode just to start off with. And we might just pull that back a little bit. So the aim today is 7th or above. It is going to be a difficult race from 13th and 14th. But what are you going to do? It happens, right? It's the name of the game. In Holt starts off on pole. Let's see who starts off last. Gonzalez. Anyway, guys, one red light, two red light, three red light, four and five, and we are underway for the Yokohama Japanese race, named after a racing tire, and Lara is going to get balked. They're all going to get balked because our lane, there was a lot of slow drivers in our lane from Blanc, I should say, and right now we're up to 11th and 13th from the start. Everyone is off into a very aggressive start. And it looks like Lara's going to try to make her way through, but it's a very seesawy track at the moment. Very seesawy in the way that it goes back and forth, and there's a lot of cars going side by side into each of these corners. Lara trying to make a move for that ninth position. Is she going to slip under? Yes, she slips under in the ninth. She follows Blanc through, but unfortunately, who's that? Fisher fights back on that corner. And Lara is now going to be a sitting duck, which she is, to Espinoza. Partner is still in 13th, so we're up from the start. The first lap, we started 13th, 14th. Lara has gone up three positions. Partner has stayed where he is. So that's a good start for us, and everyone's starting to wind back their car right now. So we might start to do the same, because it's about sticking to our strategy for one stop, and we don't want to keep pushing the car, because that's when the reliability of the car starts to fall completely out of the window, as we know. Lara has the better car of the two. Partner might have to stop for one or two parts. We'll have to weigh up what they are to see if it's worth. But the main thing is to try and to get in the top 10 for both cars to score much needed championship points. And most of the cars here, look at that, tyres. Super softs, then a softs, then medium tyres. So the guys at the back might try to overcut everyone, or might not even stop at all. It's a bit of a risky strategy because everyone is going to be held on as the race goes on. And it looks like Partnan is able to get by, who was it, Gonzalez, who started last, remember. So Partnan flicks through to 13th, following Lara, and Lara has a bit of a gap now, back to 11th. Chu, who's our original driver from season 1, but that's because we've kind of wound our car back. And how are we looking for tyres at the moment? We might put them into conserve mode in just a second, once that gap starts to wind up and I feel a little bit more comfortable with the distance between all the cars. But the main thing is, we're not currently being held up and we're not wasting tyres because of being, you know, backed up behind anyone. At the moment, Partner is catching, so let's put him back into conserve mode. Lara doing a good job catching up to this pack, and she wants to make a move, and she's going to make that move, and she makes a stick by Blanc. She's moved up into 11th spot. She is a fighter every step of the way. She does 371 kilometers per hour past that speed trap. Now it looks like Partner is keen to jump in on the action himself. I might just wind Lara's car into conserve mode, get that temperature down. It was good while it pushed, but Partner is under attack as well. He moves back into 14th position. Who is that? He's currently fighting with Gonzalez, who has been on a run all the way from the rear of the grid. Partner might start to get suckered here a little bit, because once they start falling back, so we have a virtual safety car. Is there any means for us to start to come in? What happens with the virtual safety car? No safety car comes out, but we all slow down. That is because Lundqvist has crashed off the track, which didn't affect us. It was one of the back markers, which means everyone slows down. So, how are we looking for tyres and everything else? Everything else looks pretty good. Usually under a virtual safety car, we could have pitted and everyone still would have had to keep doing their slower pace, but that's not going to happen because, you know, we kept, it was only a 24 to 23 second virtual safety car, which is one of the shortest safety cars ever done. In this championship, in the World Championship, there are safety cars and virtual safety cars. So there's two, and they both operate differently. The safety car would actually come out the track, do a couple of happy laps, usually two, and then it would go in, and we would probably have pitted then if that was going to be the case. But Lara, now over all the rear of Chu, wanting to make that move. Will she be able to make that move? She doesn't want to become vulnerable to Blanc. She doesn't want to lose that spot as well. And if she can make the move, that's going to put us into the points just for 1 point in the championship. And the commentators are just saying Enrique Lara is defending 11th place from Samuel Blanc. And it looks like Blanc is going to be able to kick her own. Wow, it's going to start raining. That just started happening out of nowhere, didn't it? So what do we want to do? Do we want to pit? It looks like it dries out. It looks like it's wet for a couple of laps and then it starts to dry out immediately. So I think it's worth just sitting out there for another lap. It would have been great to go in the pits right now as everyone's gone past the pit lane for intermediates. But if that is not going to adjust, it's not going to increase, there's no point of us doing anything differently. Look at that. It's going to go back down after lap 8. So let's just stick it out there a little bit longer. Is anyone else going to pit? No one is going to pit. So there you go. So that's the strategy. Lara now getting sucked into it, and there's going to be a bit of a spray as it rains more and more. Partner drops down at 15th, so it's going to be a bit of a race to see who can fight their way into the points. Lippin on pits. He pits for soft tyres. He's going to come out. She wants to come on for inters. We're going to have to ignore that call. Very unfortunate, because in after lap 7, it does get a lot cooler. There is no point coming in just yet. Lara circling around 11th. She's acting as a bit of a safety car. And the fog lights come out on the track. That's really cool. So it's become dark enough for the fog lights to come out. Bit of a midnight race, even though it's not midnight. That's a pretty cool feature of this game. And I haven't seen that before. So something to kind of take away. And Lara currently still defending 11th. What? How's everyone else going? Holtz. Tyres is 28%. Saarinen second, Wexler third, Sharp fourth, Schmidt fifth, sixth for Bergman, seventh for Fischer, eighth for Solander, Ninth for Espinosa, who's going to pit with 21% tyres. Chu is 10th. Ooh, Gonzalez 11th. Surikov is 12th. 13th for Alara, who's now gone down a couple of places, which is really unfortunate. And we might be able to do just one to two more laps. It's about sticking out there and making the most of these tyres and pitting when we have to. We don't have to pit just yet. It's this race. We might not even be able to finish in the top 10, which will be devastating. Holtz goes in the pits, Wexler pits, Sharp pits. So the big thing here is if it started to rain now, this would be the perfect time. Well, started to rain a couple laps, this would be the perfect time to hold out a little bit longer and then pit. But that might not be the case. Starting to dry out, the track comes back to everyone. And the guys who are pit, some of them are going to come out in front of us. So they've already pitted, and we're that far behind from the front guys. So we're just going to keep a cheeky eye on this weather. I might actually pit for Lara now. And I might just put her into attack mode, make the most of it. Currently coming 11th. Partner is fighting for that 12th spot. Can't get his way by Blanc, who's been fighting with the entire race. We're going to start to push Lara onto those tyres as fast as you possibly can. This is about getting her around and pitting this lap. Partner now drops another place while he's fighting for that 12th place. So it's been a really back and forth race for us. Is it going to rain anytime soon? No, I'm just watching it. And it's just going to get hotter and hotter. So we want to pit. Who's this in front of us? That is, Surikov is going to pit now. So we go past Surikov just before we go into the pits. We're going to go for soft tyres. Everything looks good park condition wise. We're going to do a fast stop because I wanted to get in there and out as fast as she possibly can. Partner will do another lap. And we're going to get him to start to open up the tyres. Get him into push mode. Go around as fast as you possibly can, Chief. Because the track is going to get hotter and hotter. And that means, unfortunately for him, that it's not going to rain, it's just going to keep getting more grippier. But Lara's going to come out, and I'm going to get her to push the entire way because that's 100% tyres, 100% of tyre rubber left, and we just want to get her to push, push, and push again. These tyres will last more than 6 laps, even if we push and they start to go in the red zone. So what are we going to do with Artie? Does he need to have any of his components fixed? We could fix his suspension, we could fix his gearbox, we could fix his brakes. But you know what? We're only 5 laps away. Is it worth it? Probably not, because he's outside of the points. If we fix it, he's definitely not going to be in the points. So I might just, you know what? I might just fix his suspension. And what are we going to do? We're going to come in for a fresh set of tires. Suspension, it's going to be an 8-second fix. And he's going to drop to 15th. Gearbox, he'd drop back to 18th. That would be devastating for us. So we're just going to do the suspension, which is going to be 22 up to 48. I think it's going to be much needed. Everything else we can't really do unless we don't lose too many places. I know if I get this wrong, there's going to be someone in the comment section down below who says, oh, you shouldn't have fixed it. Or they're going to say, well, you should have fixed it if we blew up. But we'll see how this goes. So that's the pitch strategy. It's going to be a fast stop. New tyres. In he goes. And while he's going, I'm going to see if the track is going to get wetter or wetter. Because it's really important that we fix the strategy. I'm just waiting to see if that telemetry is going to flick to rain out of nowhere. And it's not going to do it. We are going to come into the pits. Let's watch you stop. How's he going to pit? Is it going to be a fast stop? Tires go on. 1, 2, 3, 4 tires are done. It's good. Suspension is good for fixing as well. It's an 8.6 second stop. Lara goes up into 12th position. Actually, no. She goes up into 10th. Back in down to 11th now. Now into 10th, given that pass. So now, we are going to get Partner to push as fast as he can. He's got the tyres to do it. He's got enough fuel all the way to the end, as well as Lara, because they have excess fuel. Let's just burn it off. Lara goes through in the 9th position. She is fighting with Morona. And now, Bergman is the next person who we want to go against. And he is that far ahead, it's not even funny anymore. So this is about trying to get up as fast as you possibly can and hoping that someone else has a mechanical failure this late into the race that we can make that extra 2 spot. And that, just as we said that, Bergman, mechanical issue comes up. How long is that going to last for? We don't know at this stage. What is the fuel looking like for Lara at the moment? She crosses the line with 4 laps of fuel exactly left. Partner will be the same. He's going to pass and 15th, balls to the wall. We want to try and get him into the top 10. He goes around 400 kilometers. I haven't seen that from him before. And we're going to get him to go into medium mode now, just to finish off this race. As for Lara, in 8th, so she's in the points. I'm pretty happy with that. It'd be great if she can get into 7th, which would get our sponsor bonus, which is what our targets are. 3 laps remaining. Holtz just passes the line. Who's ahead of us next? Espinoza. Espinoza is quite far up the rest of the track. However, Bergman is up further with that technical issue. There is still a lot of laps to go around, and we might just put her back onto medium mode. What's her lap time like? She's only just coming on in the last part of this race. A 1:22 versus a 1:25. So this overcutting might have helped us, because right now she's digging through her tyres. They are off the Richter scale, but she's getting the performance she needs out of those to be competitive. And that's the main thing now. Partner's race is pretty much over, unless someone else can have a bit of a technical issue. All of his parts seem to be sitting in there fine. Lara's components, her brakes are now starting to suffer. They're on... We can't pit for you, unfortunately. They're down to 17%. If we pitted, guess what? We get out of the points. And yeah, that would be hugely unfortunate for us. We're just going to have to keep pushing here, hoping that she can grind up enough onto 7th position. Tieva, his gearbox, unfortunately, mate, just keep driving around. That is the message we're going to be sending. And how is Bergman going? Bergman is currently into 5th, but Espinoza, mechanical issue. So is Serenin. And this is the luck that we needed. Serenin is breaking down with 2 laps to go, and he goes off. So he's off the driving line. We go straight through. That is huge for us. Lara currently under Hunt from Fisher. So the rest of this race, we are just going to keep watching Lara, making sure she gets into that championship. And how are the tyres going? They're at 40%, so let's just go down, back down to neutral. Yeah, they're burning up at a really, really fast rate, aren't they? 38%. Enough to finish the race. Go back into conserve mode. Someone else is smoking in front of us, so this might be the lucky break that we need to secure that 7th, because we might be under a little bit of pressure from Fisher. How fast is he? He did a 1:22 and we did a 1:24 with a gap of 4 seconds. So we're going into the final lap now. What's our time? We just did a 1:24. The car in front of us did a 1:32, which is Bergman. That's who we were hoping to have a bit of a breakdown. And he goes down on that last lap. That is really unfortunate for him. How is Partner going? He's going to have plenty of gas to go around on. Lara, 6th position. No one else around it. How is that park condition going? But 4% for the brakes. 4%. So, are we able to catch the car in front of us, or should I just start backing away now? We're already starting to back away. The driving style is the conserve mode. I don't think we're going to be able to get this 5th position. Suspension is down to 17%. Brakes down to 4%. We don't want to break down on the last 2 corners. Ooh, there's another car ahead that's spewing. Who is it? Who is it? Who is it? And we go down into 5th position. We go down into 4th position on the last corner, on the final straight. We're able to move on. How's Partner going? How is he going? He's in 12th. Can he make another 2 spots just to nibble into the points? That would be huge. We've moved up into 4th position on the final lap. He's not going to be able to do it. He's going to get held up here like a bit of a train. He finally goes through. But 11th position just misses out on the points. There is a very... look at the amount of debris on the track, the amount of broken down cars. I can't believe it. That first half of the race was very unexciting, very uneventful. Only until that last bit did it all seem to happen. And we were very close to getting another podium. Where is Holtz? Holtz finishes a 9th. So she was one of the cars that broke down. And as you can see, the car is just completely out of it. So we move up into the points quite convincingly in 4th. Very unfortunate not to get Partner and just to nibble that 1 point. 1 point could be the difference between winning or losing this championship, given how close it's going to be. Our car is going to keep getting better and better and better and better, and that's what we want to keep doing. Rule break is low. I'm actually really pumped up right now. Nina's going to get the bonus for doing the fastest lap. Very unfortunate to miss out there. Samuel Blunt comes out. You know, again, someone's going to say, you know, you could have got Partner in if you fixed his, if you didn't fix his brakes, but you know what, he probably would have broken down. So I think I think it needed to be done. Very unfortunate. But we're only 7 seconds behind that. So as the championship goes on, I imagine this is going to get a lot more difficult to just win like that. We can't rely on other cars breaking down, because their reliability is going to keep increasing upon increasement. But yeah, that was really good. So I'm quite happy with that. I hope you're pleased with that. If you're pleased with the result, give us a thumbs up. We are making inroads. We are making a load of cash. Look at Lara. She's getting all these positive plus changes. Positive plus for braking, cornering's going up, smoothness, consistency, adaptability, feedback, focus. So she's probably going to be our go-to driver for the rest of the championship while her stars start to fill up, while she gets her potential. She's only 21 years old, so she's got a long road to go. And we came fourth. Chairman is really happy with that. Money, 2.8 mil. Can't complain with that. And that is going to put us back in the positive. What are we going to do with it? Are we going to spend on the next building, on the infrastructure? We're going to keep spending on the car. Be sure to check out episode number 3, which is sure to come out just after this the following day. So please check it out. Hit that subscribe button. And yeah, be sure to give me your feedback and your comments down below if you're liking the series so far, guys. And I will check you out later.